Every 15 minutes, someone in our country dies from an alcohol-related vehicle accident. The student being removed from your classroom today will represent one of 96 people who will be involved in an alcohol-related accident during the next 24 hours and will die as a result of that accident.
Now the time has come. Time has come today.
This time I'm going to place you under arrest for driving while intoxicated. Okay, put your hands behind your back. Spread your feet apart for me, okay?
Responding to your facility with an 18-year-old female, patient from a motor vehicle collision, significant head injury. We have some response to stimulus to the face, but we have no response to any other stimulus anywhere on the body. ETA to your facility is about 10 minutes. Current vital signs, heart rate of 120, sinus tachycardia, blood pressure 80 over 60.
Hey, Doc, your daughter Elsa, as you know, has been involved in a very significant car crash. She is currently awake. She is fairly groggy.
Okay.
But she does have a severed spinal cord in her neck. So she is right now quadriplegic. She can breathe. She can communicate. She has no mobility or motion of her arms and no sensation. This is most likely going to be a permanent condition. She is still not out of the woods yet. The next 72 hours will be critical, okay?
So I'm going to place you in the cell. I have to do a 20-minute observation period, and then we'll do the breath test like I explained it to you before, okay? I sit right down. You just sit there, 20 minutes. I'll get you on your breath test, and then we'll get going. Aggravated vehicle homicide.
Section 125.14. Manslaughter, first degree. We're going to do the breath analysis now, okay? The data master, the instrument that I told you about. You understand that?
Okay.
You have to do what I tell you to do, and then we're going to go see the judge, and then we'll go.
My car's coming.
Your car's totaled, dude. Your car's totaled, and your friend's dead.
You're aggravatedly drunk. You're a 0.24, okay? That's way over the legal limit of 0.08.
You're more than two times the legal limit, which is an aggravated DWI. Okay, it's a felony. So I'm going to read you what I'm going to charge you with, and then we're going to go see the judge.
Is there anything I can do right now? Anything?
No, right now you just need to stay quiet. Put that away for me. Coming through.
On April 21st, 2016, at 8200 East Seneca Turnpike in the town of Manlius, at approximately 1 o'clock in the afternoon, while in an intoxicated condition, you did fail to stop at a posted stop sign, causing your vehicle to strike another vehicle, ultimately causing the death of passengers Melissa Buckland. You're charged with a Class B felony. Operate a motor vehicle in the 8200 block of East Seneca Turnpike, the town of Manlius, with a blood alcohol concentration of 0.24. as determined using the chemical analysis in your breath. I'm going to set this down, because there's at least three felony charges here, I'm going to set this down for a preliminary hearing. In light of the seriousness of the charges and the fact that he could leave this community based on what he's facing with these charges, I'm going to set bail $250,000 cash, $500,000 bond. With that, I'll sign the commitment letter. Please remain down to the Criminal Justice Center. And we have the preliminary hearing set for next Tuesday. All right?
Thank you.
Thank you. There you go. So this is an 18-year-old male. He was involved in the MBA. He was ejected from the vehicle. There you go. There was a DOA also on the car accident. He has been unconscious, unresponsive for us. He was found not breathing, but he does have a 902, and at this time it's been working great for us. Vitals have been declining. Our last set was 40, size 3 not monitored. It's been hypotensive, it's been falling down. We do have stage 14 in the right AC, and just finished up our last 1,000 value. That's pretty much all I have. You have any questions?
This is the end, and that you want it. Don't pray. The damage is done. Police are coming. So slow now. I would have died. I would have loved you.
What are his pupils doing?
They're fixed.
Okay. Any respiratory activity?
No.
Okay. So we've given blood, we've given epi, he's got fluid in the belly, and no wall motion, so I think any further attempts will be futile. Time of death is 16:34. Hi, you're Ben's parents?
Yes, we are.
Okay, I'm Dr. Olson. As you know, Ben was involved in a very severe car crash this afternoon. And I'm very sorry to tell you that he died. His injuries were severe and significant. And he, there was just too much damage to survive.
Okay.
So we'll bring you down and let you see him.
April 6, 1998. Melissa Margaret Buckland just turned 18.
Melissa is a people person, and she was always making sure that she was in the crowd. The light is always on in the room. When I come home, she's usually studying or doing something in her room. And not having that light on and that door open will be an empty space, so we'll miss that.
I think Melissa's goal in life was to make everybody happy. Melissa was so spunky and just so full of life.
Has pled guilty to section 125.14 subdivision 4 of the penal law, which is aggravated vehicular homicide, which is a class B felony. And he's also pled guilty to an E felony of driving while intoxicated. Mr. Corso, you have an opportunity to say something if you want to. Is there anything that you'd like to say on the record?
I know I'm a good person, and now there's nothing I can do to ever fix everything, but I just know deep down I'm a good person.
Mr. Corso, I have no doubt that you are a good person. I've read the pre-sentence report. You did well in school. You've been accepted to a college. You've been involved in student activities. You've done everything that a good son would do. But unfortunately, what you did was you did an act that killed two other people, two of your friends. Nothing I can do and sentence you can take those things away from you, those you'll live with for the rest of your life. I wish you good luck in prison. It's a very difficult place. But again, the two friends that you killed don't have the option. So with that, I sentence you to 20 years in prison.
When someone dies, our opportunity to communicate with that individual is gone forever. As a representative of those who will die in an alcohol-related accident, your fellow classmates are going to return as a member of our Walking Dead. They will not be permitted to communicate with friends, family, or faculty for the next 24 hours. We ask that you please respect their role, one that represents an actual person who will die in the next 24 hours.
Let me see your face. This can never happen.